Welcome to Unlock Your First Six Figures blog, not blog talk, I'm sorry, morning show. I'm your host, Shay Cannon. I'm an award-winning fractional chief operating officer with the exclusive clientele of six and seven figure CEOs. However, I have a mission, and that mission includes you, entrepreneurs and small business owners who are spinning their wheels and struggling to get to their first six figures in business. I want to show you how to make the money and create time freedom. Let's make the money and create time freedom. My freedom looks like living and working my business from anywhere in the world. I started this journey in Belize, did all kind of stuff, Mexico, Argentina, back in Belize. I'm sorry. I don't know where I am. Where am I? Mexico. I'm back in Mexico, y'all. Living my best life and working my best business. In a minute, I'm going to wake up. I don't know. We're going to get into it, though. Okay, so it all starts with the blog. The blog for this week is at shaycannon.com/graduate. If you are on the Facebook side, it is in the caption if you want to click and check that out. Okay, what we've been talking about this week has been small business growth stages and how to graduate to the next stage. So there are stages to growing your business, okay? No matter what kind of business you have, no matter what kind of level of business that you have. However, in my experience as a fractional chief operating officer to small businesses and entrepreneurs, having my own business as an entrepreneur over the years and being a serial entrepreneur, really, since I was a child, right? And being a coach to businesses, what I know is most of the stages I saw described didn't really resonate with what I know you guys were experiencing. So I came up with four stages that I know will resonate. The first stage is transactional, right? When you basically are giving somebody something for some money, right? That's the first stage. And if you want to know how to go from that stage to the next stage, which is survival, then I need you to catch Tuesday's replay because we had part one in there, stage one. Stage two is survival stage. That was also on Tuesday. But survival stage is basically when you realize I really do want to do this business thing, but I recognize with just what I'm doing, it can't go like this, right? And I need more people. So how do you get out of that? Go back to Tuesday's replay because it had part one and part two. So yesterday we talked about part three or stage three, and that was capacity. Capacity is when you start to get more business and now you see you need more help, more support. Okay. You need to open your capacity. Okay. And so how do you get out of that? Well, go to yesterday's replay. Okay. We talked about it extensively. Today, we're going to talk about the fourth and final stage, which is scale. It's scale, S-C-A-L-E, in case my Alabama is getting in the way, okay? But the difference between growth and scale is growth is just when anything gets bigger or anything is more. You get more of something. It grew, right? But everything that grows doesn't grow good. It doesn't grow well, right? It just grew. It's just more, right? So what you often find as you start to get in more business is you're getting more business, so your revenue grows, but your stress grows, right? How you're handling things gets worse. You might even be making a bad reputation for yourself because the way you're handling the growth isn't professional enough because it's just you, or it's just you and a few people, and it needs to be more people, or the people you have aren't doing things the way you need to do them, so they're getting to the customer in not a good way, right? So growth is just more. It's just bigger. Scale is growth in excellence, right? It's ways that you find to grow and meet that growth with excellence. That means you're not stressed out. That means everybody's handling everything well. Things are going well. You can handle an unlimited a number of people, right? Or close to it, right? But in scale, you still have growing pains, right? And that's when the system starts to break, you know, you need to look at the processes and things you have in place again. But let's talk about it, right? So scale, this stage marks the breaking and rebuilding of everything, okay? You have to identify what is working and do more of that. Identify what is not working and do less of that, right? You have to be clear on your values to make sure all decisions fall in line to create a culture. Now, most of you, when you think of culture, you think of just with teams. No, the culture is still your mission, vision, your brand promise. Culture is internally in your business, and it should be in your outward touch points, right? If you believe in something, if you value something, if you have a mission and a vision, it should show in how you treat your clients and how you make all decisions, okay? So you have to create processes. That's what to do. procedures, how to do it, and protocols, when to do it, okay? And that will make up systems for a well-oiled machine that becomes your operations, all right? So I know some of y'all are like, oh, that's how all that fit together? Yes, that's how all that fits together, okay? This stage is usually the stage where you really start to build a business and not just do business, okay? You start to build a business and not just do business. There are levels to scale. The more you grow, the more you have to repeat the process and overhaul everything. But at least by the time you're creating systems and working those systems as a well-oiled machine, you're probably hitting your first six figures, right? And then, of course, that first six figures will break when you go into multiple six figures. Multiple six figures will break when you go into the million, and so on. So every time you hit a new capacity, a new growth spurt, you have to look at what needs to change and be updated. I want you to think about it like when you were young, right? You were excited to go clothes shopping, right? Your parents weren't that excited. Why? Because you grew and it was a necessity. They had to get you more clothes. The old clothes didn't fit anymore. They weren't functional for you anymore. But those weren't the clothes that you would have all your lifetime. You kept growing. So there kept being points where they had to take you shopping to get you clothes as a necessity, right? Because you were outgrowing those clothes. You have to look at your business the same way, okay? Every time you put something in place, if you continue to grow, some of the things that you put in place won't work anymore. So you have to pay attention to those things and update them so they can handle your new capacity and growth scale, all right? So it's a never-ending thing, but it's a great problem to have, let me tell you, okay? It might not feel like it in the moment, but at the end of the day, if you aren't doing well, then the systems that you had in place would still be working. Okay. Now let's make it plain. The key characteristics of scale, it involves deep strategic planning. If your focus is on what works and eliminating what doesn't work, it's about building a sustainable business model that can not only grow, but scale, which is growth and excellence. Okay. The challenges with scale is that you have to maintain your balance. Okay, between growth and maintaining the company's values and cultures and the systems that you have put in place. Okay, so additionally, you're gonna have to start creating scalable systems, processes, or whatever, but you have to keep an eye on them, you have to monitor them, you have to pay attention when things aren't working as expected. All right, advancement. Well, we already know you'll still be in scale, you'll just be at different levels of scale. And so, what it takes is process improvements. Adherence to your core values, strategic decision-making, all of that is key. So entrepreneurs must focus on building a culture that supports growth, innovation, and customer satisfaction. That is scale, right? Instead of going around, how many of y'all have at least a toe in scale at this point? Let's see. Somebody come off the mic. Who has a toe in scale at this point? I know Heather does. So Heather, come off the mic. I don't know what you over there doing. You have at least a toe in scale.
I don't feel like I do. Okay, explain this to me, because I was like, that's not me.
Okay, because you're at the beginning. So you have a body in capacity, but you got a toe in scale, because even with the capacity, you're having to build these systems that are going to be rinse and repeat, right? Mm-hmm. So, but do you see how you can get the rest of your body in the scale eventually? Yes. And how scale has different levels.
Yes. Now that the first part of the explanation. Yes. Now I see exactly what you're talking about. Exactly. Because people, I have to have systems in place, processes, so that it can be wash, rinse, repeat. You know, every. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
That makes sense.
Okay. So I wanted to start with you because you were the closest, right? But now I'm going to go around. So Kimberly, since you're driving and you possibly can talk to us, what is this in my way? Okay, thank you. If you could unmute safely, please unmute safely. What I want to know for you is, I know that you have, some parts in survival and some parts in capacity, but do you at least see your way to scale?
I do see my way to scale. I know that it's be done. I'm still in a space of trying to, like, survival, trying to figure out how I'm going to do it, but I'm still in that space of survive, or, you know, just I don't know how to explain it. I'm trying to articulate what I'm feeling.
Let me tell you, because see, this is the thing. I know that's how I came up with these stages, right? So survival kind of has you in a chokehold, but you see where capacity can help you out of that chokehold of survival. And at least way down the road somewhere, that is a hike, it's a mountain. You see it all the way, but you see where scale is. You're just nowhere near it. I understand. I got you.
Right.
So is that right?
Yes.
So that's all I want to make sure is that you can at least see the scale, right?
Yes.
That's
absolutely.
All.
I can see it.
All right.
Yes.
Dawana, you are in capacity. Do you see scale? Do you know how to get from capacity to scale?
Well, actually, I'm deep in survival. I have a toe in capacity, and I understand and see scale, and I understand what I would need to do to scale. So you made you made it make sense in terms of the SOPs and, you know, making sure that you had basically defining the rinse, wash, rinse, and repeat cycles of my business. So you've made that part make sense. So I don't think I'm looking at scale, mm-hmm. but I ain't got no pieces, no body parts in it.
No problem. Okay, I'm trying to get all this Rachel Rogers stuff ready over here, and it's all in the way. Okay. And this billionaire code is in the way too. Move, y'all. Okay. Tracy, we know you're kind of in survival. You know how to get to capacity, do you? And do you see scale?
Well, you're right. I'm in survival, getting to capacity, and I can see myself getting to scale.
Yeah, that's all I'm asking. That's all I'm asking.
Yeah.
Because see,
yeah.
This is the thing. Being aware gets you ahead of it. So at least you can recognize it. You're going to have to go back when you're in it, in the pain of it, and be like, I don't remember what I'm supposed to do. You know what I'm saying? But at least now you can see it. Like it makes a little sense. You see what I'm saying? That's mm-hmm. what I'm trying to achieve right now. I don't want mm-hmm. y'all to feel like, oh, off this 1 week conversation, you're supposed to be in scale. No, it don't work that way. But now that you know what these stages are, right? You know where you are, you know how to get to the next part, and you at least see yourself being able to go further. That's all I'm asking. So is that working for you, Trace?
Yes, ma'am. I got it.
Cool beans. Okay, Glow. Tell me what stage you're in, and can you see the next stages?
What I mentioned earlier this week is that I'm in survival and going into transactional, I think it was. And
no, transactional is the first one. So you're already did, you know, sold something for money.
Oh,
got a taste of it and wanted to continue to do it. So yes, you're in survival. The next one is capacity, right?
Okay.
And the next one after that is scale. So all I'm asking is, while you're fully immersed in survival, do you at least see how you're supposed to get to capacity? And do you see way, way down the line where scale is?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, cool. Then I have done my job for you for this week. Teray has the luxury of being able to take her time and stuff, see her way through a little more. Teray, tell the people where you are, what you see next, and what you see about scale.
Good morning. I'm walking out of the orthodontal office. We just finished up.
Okay.
I'm in the I don't care phase right now. I don't give
That's
a
fun.
I don't give a F phase right now. Like, I think I'm in the transactional phase right now. I'm not even thinking about scaling, but I do. I'm right now. I kind of want to grow right now.
Okay.
But I want to grow at my pace right now.
Yes.
If that makes any sense.
It does.
I want to grow in slow motion right now. I don't want to hustle. So, but I don't mind growing as long as it doesn't require too much of my time and energy and effort right now. There are other things that I'm, you know, are priority for me right now. So growing is not. I do want to grow, especially whenever I see those dollar signs coming through, and then I'm like, oh, growing don't sound. But that's where I am. I want to get through the next couple months first, you know, because I have some other things planned. This year is different for me right now. But I want to get through some other things first, and then I want to start putting time on my calendar to work on growth, and before I can get to, you know, scaling and some other things, and then I'll work on, you know, building a team or whatever else. Yeah. I was impressed. Let me just say, I was impressed with my publisher. She is a young mom. She has a toddler and an infant. She lives here in Atlanta, and she has a toddler and an infant. She's running two businesses. She's a chef. She's an author, and she has her own publishing company. She's helping authors write books, publish books. And she, when I tell you, she's running a house. She's nursing. She's got an infant and a 4-year-old. And she is running, but when I tell you she has a team,
yeah,
because she's like, you know what I mean? She's over here like, okay, yeah, we'll get those, you know, which book cover are you looking at? Okay, so I'll get my team member to send those over to you. Like, she's calling the shots, but she has a team.
Yes.
So, you know, and she's efficient and she's able to meet with me. I'm like, how do you have time to respond to me on a Sunday and you're cooking dinner and you know what I mean? She'll be on a Zoom call with me. That's what
delegation can do for you.
That's what delegation can do. Like, she's bouncing a baby, and then her mom comes into the screen, takes the baby, and then she's like, and I'm looking at her like, I'm not trying to run no business.
But you're looking at delegation and support at work. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, exactly. She's running the businesses, and she's doing cooking videos, and she just wrote another book. While she's helping me publish mine. She was publishing her second book while she was helping me publish my book, while she's nursing the baby and she's teaching the alphabet to the other baby and she's cooking dinner for her family. Like, she's doing all the things. And I'm like looking like, meanwhile, she's looking at me making ice cream. Like, can I have some? Like, I'm, you know what I mean? Talking to me on the phone, discussing stuff.
Look, land the plane, Teray. Look, we're a fan of her too. Now, land
I'm sorry. Plane. But I'm saying all that to say that I want to be able to get to that level where I want to be able to delegate on that level and take my hands off and let it run on its own and just be able to delegate and, like, you know, be in it for an hour or two here and then take my hands off and let it run by itself. But I'm not there yet mentally, but I want to be.
Maybe not, but... So what you need to start reading are books like Clockwork, you know, Running Your Business, whatever, by Mike Michalowicz. You need to be reading books like Who, Not How, right?
Mm-hmm.
Because what's going to happen is you just need more capital.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying? You can't bootstrap starting with team. You're going to need more capital because what needs to be done and who's going to do it, because it's not you. You see what I'm saying? So that just needs more of an investment.
Mm-hmm.
It can be done. That if you go back to the beginning of the blog, that's how corporations do it. They start with money, right? Mm-hmm. And then they have a plan. And then they disperse the money based on the plan. And the plan is never that the owner of the business does sometimes any damn thing.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying? If the owner happens to be the CEO, they still aren't doing, they're only doing the visionary stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So those are the books that if you have the luxury of being able to start there, that's where you start.
Mm-hmm.
You do your plan so that you can know what needs to be done, and then you figure out who gonna do it, because it ain't you.
Mm-hmm.
There you go. So Who, Not How, and Clockwork by Mike Michalowicz. Clockwork has a subtitle that I can't remember right now.
Mm-hmm.
But I've even been in, so Mike Michalowicz wrote the book, but he and Adrian Dorison came up with Clockwork, like the actual coaching program. I've been through that coaching program. It's great. It's going to help you be efficient, but it's teaching you through the point of you not doing everything and getting your business to the point that it runs without you.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So that's where you need to go.
Yep.
But
yep.
Most people most of us don't have that luxury. So we're going to start with building it out from us out, right? And so, but yes, but even building it from us out, you'll see the different stages come into play when you're finding the who, not the what, I mean, the who, not the how, right? You don't need to know how to do stuff because you're not going to be the one to do it. Or I should say, you should not be looking to do the how. You need to find somebody to do the how, right? But you'll still see your stages in there. Like, you'll see that, okay, we grew. So now having one person do this thing who is almost like an all-purpose person, now we need to go into the actual specialties of a thing. You see what I'm saying? In fact, this is a great time to bring Letitia on. Letitia, you are the only one here that is in scale right now. You have a team. You have a team that does special things, but we're at the point now where we have broken that. And we now have to find the next level of scale, and we have to go deeper into specialties. As a CEO, when you had things that were running smoothly and now they have broken, can you talk a little bit about that for everybody? Yeah, you, get off the mic. Or should I say, get on the mic? Nah, baby, don't play with me. You the tech person. Don't act like you having tech problems. Y'all see this shit? No, she tried it. She tried it, y'all.
Good morning, everyone. Mm-hmm. So I used to be the solopreneur. I did all the things. And then I hired Shay. Just a little bash. Hired Shay is my first hire was not a VA. It was a thinker. And it was Shay. And so it took me a while to get where I'm at. But I'm going to tell you, if I would have listened, I would have done it faster, to be honest with you guys. So it took me a while because Shay was like, well, you got to hire. I'm like, no, I'm going to do it. If I stop, they're not going to think I'm technical. And so when I hired the first person, I literally boxered Shay and was like, girl, I'm going to bed at 9 o'clock. And it felt really, really good. So once you get clarity around your art, but here's the thing that I think people mess up because they come to me for tech help. I can't help unclear people. So once I got clarity around my offer, my audience, and my services, it was easier to hire a second thinker to help me with the vision and implementing the vision. So yeah, we did build a team, and we have a team now. And it is a little broken because now we have quantity on our actual offer. So when it was one or two people, it was easy. When it became 3, 4, 5, and 6 people, and then they started. So now I've kind of dipped my toe back into some stuff I shouldn't, according to Shay. But I think if I would tell anybody, I don't even know what I'm supposed to be talking about. But I would think
you're doing good.
Get faster on clarity offer so that you can get your thinker and then you can get your doers. That would be if I had any advice to give people. And then that will get you faster to what it's supposed to be going to, scale or grow.
Scale. Well, it depends. They're in different places, but it will get them faster to scale, period.
Well, get you faster to out of solopreneurship because solopreneurship is absolutely exhausting. It's exhausting mentally and physically, you know, and it really limits what your revenue could be. Most of you want an increase in revenue, but you cannot get that increase in revenue without a team. Let me just be very honest with you guys. This is not my first business. This is actually my second business. My first business I've had for 27 years, and we have a whole team. So you can't get there without it. So all of these strategies that Shay shares with you, I'm her personal one-on-one client. She shares that with me as well. But the faster you put them in place, broken or not, the faster you can fix those issues and get the revenue that you want. And that's really the bottom line, to be honest with you, and doing a business that you love. I love what I do. Absolutely. Anybody who knows me will tell you I love what I do. Is that good?
Yeah, that was great. Thank you. I just thought that was important because they need to hear somebody that has started where they started and gotten a little further and understand that, you know, when you put stuff in place and they start working, they're still going to break. But that breaking is a testament to your growing, right? And so Letitia didn't know this, and now she's about to hear a little secret. But what my fractional COO clients don't realize is I purposely try to break all their shit. I purposely try to break everything. Because the quicker I can break it, the quicker I can get us ready for the next level. Because sometimes when I come into your business, I don't know what's working and what's not working. So I try to break it all and I see what breaks and what doesn't break. And what doesn't break, we're going to do more of that. And what does break, we're going to fix this shit. You see what I'm saying? So it's kind of like if you're going to go on a voyage with an unproven boat, you might want to get it in some water and see what these holes are because you can't just eyeball it. You see what I'm saying? So you got to get it on the water, not necessarily on the journey in the water, but you got to get it on the water and test it out so you can go ahead and start patching some shit up so that you can at least be ready for the journey. And then as the journey is coming, you can patch up stuff that happens while you're on the journey. So that's the first thing. Well, it's actually not the first thing. It's the second thing that I do when I come into a business as a fractional COO. The first thing I do is alleviate burdens. You know what I'm saying? I immediately start taking things off of my CEO, and they're now mine, right? And then the second thing I do is try to break everything. So yes, I just need you to know that, like she said, and like we just discussed it last night during the workshop, there's nothing you can do without starting with clarity, right? And we can always, and I've taught y'all so well about clarity, y'all are now recognizing when people don't have clarity. I don't even have to say nothing. Y'all be like, oh, you need a strategy session, or you need to go on, you need, because y'all know now what it sounds like to hear somebody who doesn't have clarity. And what y'all now know is all that stuff that you have invested in without clarity is not going to work for you. Not well, not the way it was intended, right? You might get a little win, but you'll never get the big win without clarity. And to be clear, there are a bunch of programs out there, a bunch of them, and all of them are valuable for somebody, but they're not as valuable as they could be if you don't have clarity. That's just the way it works. They're high level strategies. You never get to skip over the foundation to get to high level strategies. If you can imagine architecture in a building, if you don't take the time to build that foundation rock solid, yeah, you might get some height on that building, but guess what? It can't weather, right? It can't survive in weather. It can't survive, you know, people coming in, all the things. You're going to be, that building is going to fall. So when you invest in these high level strategies, right? You might see some little wins. You might get a little clarity, but then you're going to immediately hit a wall and not understand why it's not working. It's because you don't have clarity, okay? So some of the things that you're investing in that's not working for you, you're blaming the thing when you really need to look at your clarity, okay? All right, Shawana Kennedy, this week we've talked about transactional, we've talked about survival, we talked about capacity, and we've talked about scale. Now, Shawana, you got like a foot in survival, and you would be out of that thing if you would open your capacity. And I don't know why you don't have a team yet, but you don't. So Shawana, do you see your way to capacity and pass capacity into scale? Do you at least see your way?
What I saw was just how you just did that all out there in the street in the video and all loud. See, that's what I just saw. That's what just like hit me real hard.
Yeah.
And while you talking, I actually spoke to a young lady, what's today, Thursday, on Tuesday. So I have released some of the power, and we're going to test out someone new to do a couple of things. So I'm opening her up to a couple of my lighter clients. Mm-hmm. We're going to test that out with some graphic stuff. So I have done that, Shay, okay? I have done that.
All I'm saying is, you know, you got this plan, and the plan, we had even planned how to do that thing, and I just didn't see no movement, so I was, hey.
No, it's like movement. I've had a conversation with, you know, with tech on the line. You know, I'm already with the tech, so because we're going to, you know, vamp up the, you know, my site so that we can make it's doing all of the things so that my audience understand the offer, right? And the service is clear, right?
I love it. So see there's way. Movement. You see your way through capacity and to scale, right?
I do. I just want the rest of even this year, though, to be so, I don't even use the word clear because that's been used too much. I want what's going on currently where you know without fail that's what it is, like without fail. Mm-hmm. And so the goal.
So you want to be able to put things in place, and you want to be able to predict things and forecast things. Is that what you're saying?
Yes.
Yeah. So that's your processes. That's your processes. Now, let me tell you, you said something very good, which is that's another way to understand that a process may need to be upgraded when you are no longer to forecast and predict because something is different. That means it might be time to look at the system again. So thank you for bringing that up.
Oh, okay. Okay. Mm-hmm.
See how you got the accolade? Look at you. Go on, Shawana.
Okay.
Anybody finna be playing with you, Shawana?
Okay, but right. I'm excited about it. I'm excited. Yeah.
Well, thank you, Shawana. All right. Dr. Toya has joined us. Look, she didn't came out of the shadows. Look, she had joined us in the comments. Look, then we realized, oh, wait, Dr. Toya been watching us, and now you're on the morning show, Dr. Toya. Tell me what you think about this week. Tell me where you are on the in the four stages, and tell me whether or not you see yourself getting to scale.
All right. Good morning. Yes.
Good morning.
I'm transitioning. So I think I'm in survival because I don't make enough money to say that I don't have to think about that. Yes. But I'm also at capacity. So I have a team that I haven't figured out though how to best work and utilize. So I'm in the stage of figuring out how to get the team to be as productive as I need them to be so that I can effectively scale.
Yes. Okay. I'm loving that. I'm loving that. Look at you. Look, where you being, Dr. Now that we know you watching, we're going to be calling your name.
I'll be here.
Well, see, we know that a lot more people watch than comment, and a lot more people comment than that actually come on. So we get it. But thank you for coming out of the shadows and joining us. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
As I always say, I'm not the only genius in the room, although it cannot be argued that I am a genius, but y'all are geniuses too. And so the more people we get to participate and share their genius, the better. And what I know about Dr. Toya, she got some genius over there. So yes, we are, it is my honor to have you on the show. Okay, y'all, let's go into closing out this Rachel Rogers and this billionaire code, okay? Now, let's start with the billionaire code. We ended with the builder. Let's go to the $1 million mark, okay? We're dreaming big. We're going into different levels of scale with the billionaire code, okay? So the operator goes from $1 million to $3 million. The leader goes from $3 million to $10 million, okay? And I'm going to stop right there. But after that, you have the owner that goes from $10 million to $30 million. You got the investor that goes from $30 million to $100 million. And then you got the entrepreneur, which I feel like they should call that something else, but it's $100 million or more, okay? But y'all have access to it. I'm going to drop the link again today. And so y'all can go further than what I'm going today, okay? But the operator is $1 million to $3 million, okay? And what they're saying is you should be spending your time delegating. Okay. Now the funny thing is they ain't delegating to 1 million. I'm gonna tell you, you wait to 1 million to delegate, you're gonna be frazzled as fuck. Okay. You're gonna be unhealthy. So you need to start delegating before that is what I'm gonna tell you. Okay. Your focus should be on building a team. Your primary question that you're asking should be, how does my team get me ahead? Okay, so Dr. Toya, that's for you. How does your team get you ahead in the roles that you hired them for? What is their job in pushing the business forward? Okay, because everybody that you hire is not going to make money. But if they're taking things from you, you should be able to go out there and do things to make more money. So sometimes, and I'm not saying it's you, Dr. Toya, but sometimes what's happening is we hire people and we still doing some of the stuff that they doing, or we're micromanaging. So hiring them was not of a help, because we didn't do our part to let go and go out and do what we were supposed to do to go and make more money, okay? So some people that you hire, she said it's me. Look, I knew it was you. I just wasn't going to say it out loud. But okay, because at the end of the day, if you have a team and you don't know that they're helpful, most of the time it's our fault, right? Most of the time it's our fault. That we hire them, we don't trust them, we scared to let go, this our baby, all that. And what that's doing is keeping you from making money. So two reasons why you hire. One is because that person is in a money-making role and they can bring in more money in the business. Two, they're supporting you from not doing things that don't make money, right? Was that a double negative? I don't know. But anyway, let go of the things that's not making money, and they do those things, and then you are supposed to then go do the things that make the money, okay? So that's how team works. All right, let's go to the biggest hurdle for the operator is building a team and scale consistent delivery, okay? That's that brand promise, right? That's that McDonald effect I talk about. Does the Big Mac look the same and the customer, it tastes the same to the customer? The customer is satisfied every time, okay? I don't know how satisfied came out. I guess that was the Alabama. All right, what they need. You need team communication systems, okay? One thing about having a team is some of the tech that you had in place as a solopreneur or a few people, it has to change. Because now not only are you just talking to your clients, now you have to have a way to talk to your team. And it may not be the same communication tool, okay? Now that you have multiple clients, we can't just use email. You need a project management system. Come on, quit playing, okay? So As you scale, just know, you see our resident chief tech officer over there, our tech guru, how she's shaking her head. Yeah, you can't keep holding on to your little chief tech when you start adding people, because now you need new functionalities, new features, and it's possibly a whole new tech, okay? To graduate from operator to leader, you need to lead a team and train them to do what you did well, okay? So that's for Dr. Toya and all of us with teams. If we train them well and let them go, don't micromanage them, okay? Train them. Train them on how you got to the result and tell them that their goal is to get to the result, not to necessarily take your steps, okay? You want them to work your steps, but you are eliminating their genius and you're eliminating their worth and creativity when you try to hold them to the steps. Hold them to the end result, okay? That's macro managing. All right, I'll let go of that. Let's see, it says communication system added, leadership, and the rest of the team. Movement should be create the team that grows the movement, all right? Your tribe, you should be building systems to grow your tribe, right? Okay, and the team should have managers, supervisors, team members, and contractors. That's an operator, okay? Leticia said there are at least 33 processes and systems you need in your business, and most can be automated. Let me check on Facebook, make sure nobody's talking over here. Kimberly says she had to drop, but she's listening. We figured that, Kimberly. Okay, keep listening, Kimberly. All right, let's go to the leader. The leader is 3 million to 10 million, okay? You should be spending your time with delegating successfully. The focus should be becoming a leader, okay? You're not a doer at this point. Really, to me, you should have, way back, should have stopped being a doer. But basically, at this point, you're leading. You're strategy only. You're vision only. Okay, you're not the doer of anything. In fact, you don't even check on the doer. You have people that are above the doers that tell you and report to you, and they manage the doers, okay? Let's see, your primary question you should be asking is, how does my team get ahead? Okay, so remember the last question was, how does my team get me ahead? As they're getting you ahead, your goal is now, how do I get my team ahead, okay? That's when you start to invest in development and training for them and all this kind of stuff, okay? Biggest hurdle, scaling a team to consistently deliver. What they need, company communication systems. The last system was a team communication system. Now they're talking about a company communication system. To graduate, you need to recruit and onboard a leadership team, okay? That's where Leticia was talking about thinkers. Some of y'all hire teams and then you feel like they always asking me questions. I might as well do it myself. No, you're the point of contact. All of them are going to ping you because you don't have another leader and a decision maker in your on your team. So yeah, they're coming to you, right? Okay, so communication system added is leadership and multiple teams. So now you should start breaking out into departments is what he mean by multiple teams, right? Those are departments. The movement is create the team growth systems that support the movement. The tribe is build systems that grow tribe leadership. Okay. Now to put that in perspective, right? We might put systems in play to grow our tribe. That is, that was the last one, the operator. So y'all have seen me do that, right? Y'all have seen me grow our community. I have systems in place to grow. We have different things going on. I go outside of our group to tell people about how great it is so they can be invited inside the group. I have a system. But the next step for me is somebody else needs to come in and lead the community, not me. Y'all see how that works? Okay. The team for a leader are directors, managers, supervisors, team members, and contractors. So you see they added another level of leadership, right? So if we look at the McDonald's leadership, yeah, you got somebody that's on fries, on the grill, whatever, and a cashier, right? Then you have a lead. That lead might be good at what they do, but they also lead other team members. And then you have supervisors, right? So you need to have those levels at that level, okay? Now let's go to Rachel Rogers and get out of this dreamland of billionaireism. So with Rachel Rogers, we are at boss level, which is level 5, badass level, level 6, and baller level, which is level 7, which is a million, okay? So boss level is 250K to 499,999, okay? Badass is 500, half a mil, y'all, 500K to 999,999, and baller is a million plus, okay? Now, again, what I like about Rachel Rogers is she talks about mindset and she talks about the actions that keep you not moving. So let's get into it. For the first one, which is boss. Okay, the 250 to 499999. Your mindset hurdle is fear of growth. You're expanding so far out of your comfort zone at this stage that you want to run back to earlier stages and hide. Okay, thinking you are a unicorn and that you can never stop doing the client delivery and sales. Okay, fear that all of your clients will quit if you stop showing up for them directly and feeling trapped as a result, okay? continue imposter syndrome, major discomfort due to massive growth. Let me tell you something about imposter syndrome, y'all. Everybody don't necessarily have imposter syndrome. It presents differently. Some people have perfectionism, okay? And then other people have imposter syndrome. So you just have to know which one you are, right? I never feel like I'm an imposter. My ass is too arrogant. I never feel like an imposter. I'm a perfectionist, right? But either way, it's stagnating you, okay? Your growth mindset should be, trust your team members can excel at things that you've always done well. You ain't the only person that can do that thing. And guess what? The way you did it ain't the only way to do it, okay? So that should resonate from the billionaire code. The stagnating action is becoming the market and sales bottleneck. Let's talk about this, Letitia. Giving too much energy to building your list personal brand instead of focusing on managing and growing your team, wanting to throw hand grenades into your business because it's becoming so streamlined that it's maybe a little bit boring. Boring is a sign of growth. And so that's that also that what Shawana was saying, she wants it to be predictable. Well, y'all know most of the time we look at predictable as boring, but when you can predict things, that means shit is working, okay? Delaying delegating tasks that you think only you can do, hint, you are wrong. I think they talking directly to Letitia there. Okay, growth-inducing action. Hire your replacement and ruthlessly delegate what you do well, okay? Interesting. All right, let's go to the badass, which is the half a mil up to $999,999, okay? And your mindset hurdle is fear of abundance, okay? And let me tell y'all how we think we don't have a fear of abundance because we want it, but we don't understand how when we're inserting cycles of abundance, how it actually feels to us. So listen up. You have more money and less work now, and that's causing you an existential crisis. No, Alabama coming out, y'all. Fear of experiencing true abundance and sabotaging success due to mind trash around wealth. Okay, so this is where all that childhood stuff come up, all right? To get money, you got to work hard. See, at this level, you ain't working that hard, so you thinking, oh, the money ain't going to keep coming if I ain't working hard. So all that money mindset stuff starts to come into play. Not recognizing how valuable your time is. It serves your business best if you focus on doing the work that only you can do. Miss Austin. Growth mindset focus. Challenge yourself to see that your revenue can grow without it being directly tied to your time, okay? Now, stagnating actions at this level, becoming the delivery bottleneck. Wonder if somebody sees themselves. Continuing to do the majority of the work to deliver your offer. Who is that? Delaying delegating tasks that you think only you can do. Hint, you're wrong. Delaying hiring an operations manager that can help you run the business. She didn't do that, but you don't even run. Okay. Failing to keep deep dive into money mindset work. Your beliefs around money are affecting every decision you make in business. So this is a top priority, right? So let me tell y'all this. Therapy is a tool, okay? When the tools that you have are not working for the mindset you need to have, to take the actions that you need to take, that's when you need more tools, okay? Therapy is not for crazy people and mentally people alone, okay? If more people introduce therapy into their life quicker, they will be further along in life faster, just to let you know. All right, not offloading those last few clients that are you're still handling directly. Okay, so your growth-inducing action is to completely systematize delivery of your service or product, train your team to run your flagship offer without you, all right? Now, last but not least is the baller. We're at a million plus, y'all, okay? The mindset hurdle at a million And let me tell you, we're looking forward to these problems, okay? But the mindset hurdle at a million is fear of the unknown. You are struggling with your new identity as a wealthy CEO instead of struggling entrepreneur. You are having a hard time with team management and transferring success to your team. You're still getting stuck in the doing of your business. You need to hire more people, but you're afraid to do it. You may be feeling a little bit let down after working so hard to get to this point and wondering what comes next. How do you fix that? You focus on challenge your beliefs around how you contribute to success of your company. Okay? Because you're not the only one that can. You're not the only one that does. All right, stagnating actions. Becoming the operations bottleneck. Getting dragged back into the day-to-day operations because you have not established clear operating systems. Now, let me tell you how in Letitia's business, this is now me. Okay? These are my stagnating actions. I can't stay in operations because I'm in a day-to-day marketing. Okay? Delegating to your team and then taking tasks back is slowing you down and breaking trust with your team. That's me, y'all. Okay? You're struggling to train your team to understand the systems and genius that are in your head. You need to help them understand how you make decisions and do what you do, so that they're empowered to do it themselves. Again, we're talking operations. That's me. We offer Letitia now, right? Your team culture may not be documented yet, so it creates drama within your team. We don't really have drama, but we don't really have a lot of culture either, okay? As your business goes through a major upgrade, not everyone can come along with you. In other words, you may need to fire clients or team members. I'm gonna leave that in the air. Our growth-inducing action in operations is support your team to systematize operations and focus on your own personal development, okay? So that was for me, not Letitia. All right. So having shared these growth scales from Rachel Rogers, we should all be millionaires. And the billionaire code decoded from Alex Chafin. I don't know. I'll drop this in. But I would love for anybody to come off the mic and tell me what they think. You got a minute, because over here, Shay can say, oh, my God, I needed to watch this replay. She said, this is all me. Yeah, Shay, we're going to talk about that later. But yeah. What do y'all think? Did you recognize some things in there that's holding you back? Because see, some of the things are, some of these levels, like I told you, when we go to people's other official levels, you still see some glints of you in those levels. But did you see some pieces of you right now, even though the dollar amount was not the level you're on? And do you see some resolution in higher dollar amounts that you can go ahead and be putting in your business now? Those are my two questions. And this is a come off the mic and not a round robin. So do you see some pieces of you, and do you see some resolutions you can be applying now? Anybody want to come off the mic? Letitia don't have to come off the mic. I was calling her out the whole time. So it's like she's been off the mic.
Okay. I appreciate you called yourself out though too. That was good.
Yeah, of course. Of course.
So when you said, afraid of abundance. Mm-hmm. I was like, because people always say, oh, I'm afraid of failure. It's like, I'm not afraid of failure. Mm-hmm. I fail all the time. Like I'm okay with failure. But success means you have to keep doing that shit over and over again.
It does.
That scares the shit out of me.
Yeah. Yeah.
So that when you said that, I was like, oh, I felt like I got pinned to the wall. So
yeah. But now that you know that in a way that you can't escape knowing, and you've said it out loud, now you know you need to go find the tools.
Yeah.
You can't know it and then not work on it.
I've been working on it. Good. I've been working on it, but it's still, it's something that's kind of like back here. It's not so much in the forefront anymore. It's more in the back. So I've made progress that has moved from front to back, but there are still whispers. So.
Gotcha. All right. Anybody else want to add anything about the We Should All Be Millionaires Hello 7 levels or the Billionaire Code levels before we get out of here for the week? No? All right. Well, it's not too late for you to join us. Oh, look, Auntie Shaker got something to say, y'all. Oh, shit. Let's go. What she want to add? Look, she done came out the Facebook comments to come on here. What you trying to add, Shaker?
Oh, my God. OMG. Okay. I had to come off Facebook and get in the actual Zoom, because when I tell you
When I tell you that this was so, oh my God, this is so, okay, let me read this real quick, okay? Mm-hmm. I literally just wrote this yesterday, okay? I said, I just realized I am afraid of my own shadow. So my house backs up to a small lake, and oftentimes, it's just gonna be quick, and oftentimes I'll walk out my back door and just stand at the base of this body of water. Depending upon the time of day, I can catch a shadow of myself that is so big that it almost expands to the other side. In the last month, I have purchased a property in Dubai and just became a financial service agency owner. Two incredibly amazing things. I am a global brand and company now, y'all. But instead of wanting to celebrate, I want to crawl into the bed and just sleep. I dreamt of this opportunity, and I worked my ass off to get here. But why do I feel so bad? So I decided to fast. This type of insanity requires divine intervention. Well, during this morning's meditation, it was revealed that I am afraid of my own shadow. Auntie Shaky and the Financial Matchmaker brand will be a huge global brand that will impact over 100,000 families. But what will I have to give up to get there? Mm-hmm. Better yet, who? This new level requires a different type of focus and work ethic. It requires a new level of study and discipline, a new armor for new attacks. Oh my God, I think I just had an anxiety attack. Laughing, but very serious. I'm almost on the other side of this thing with the help of community. But I write this hoping I am not alone in this, but also to encourage someone to know that there are demons to fight at every level. But if you stand up to them and don't back down, you are sure to win. Cheers to a new level.
Yes. Yes. Most definitely. Most definitely.
Congratulations.
Yep. What you say? She want a pom pom around this month.
You know, right? You know it. And if I didn't have looking like Beetlejuice, I would come off just to shake my pom pom.
No, lead the picture up.
Not Beetlejuice.
That is so huge. And having an opportunity to speak to you while in Dubai was everything for me as a color girl. And I'm super proud of you. And I will be using parts of what you just said. Because it is, we do have to be okay to see ourselves in these things and in these spaces. So the first time I use it, I am going to give you credit for it. I will give you credit. But as I continue to use that as an example of people, when it's time
to become yours,
be seen and heard, you know, be seen and heard. Seriously, because that did, that touched me. It resonated with me. And that's the thing with a lot of people. They do, they want it. But then when it's time to see yourself, it's like, what the, you know, if I was in my Shea voice, what the, we need sound effects on here. That's what we need. We need sound effects on here. But congratulations. Congratulations. Congratulations.
And Shaky, let us know how we can support you. You know what I mean? Especially like me and Shawana, yes. Those of us who are in Atlanta, let us know how we can support you. Like how we can be, like we're here for you. You know what I mean?
Yes, yes, yes.
Love it. Love it. I'll tell you that the moment you think it's not hurdles to overcome and it's not fear of something, what I'm going to challenge you to do is look at some of the stuff that you're refusing to do, but that on some level, you know that if you did it, it would expand you. Look at the things that you know what I'm saying? I'm going to tell you, if you make a list of the things you're refusing to do in your business, right? If you make a list, like if you don't go live, throw that on there, right? Yeah, hide your face, Leticia. You know, so if you refuse to hire a team, throw that on there. Whatever you're not doing, put it on there. And let me tell you how you just made a list on how to get to your next level. Because most of the time, the shit that we're not doing, that we know we need to do, that we're trying to keep everything in the world from doing, our next level is actually on the other side of that. So I challenge y'all, make a list. Okay? Make a list. Because sometimes when we see that big shadow, like Auntie Shaky said, and like the information said, you start to try to recess to get back comfortable. And what we know is contentment is definitely the enemy of greatness. We know this, but we forget it when we're experiencing it because we're just trying to get out of discomfort. What makes you uncomfortable about business, but you know it's not a bad thing? Make that list, and that's probably the roadmap to your next level. Okay? What a great way to end this. Thank you, Auntie Shaky. Y'all have a great day. Have a great weekend. Don't forget, we got a free training going on in the group. Making money in your sleep. Today is the last day of it. If you missed the workshop last night, you have time to get the replay. So go ahead and get started. ShayCannon.com/digital dollars. The replay is already in the vault. You can get started and be up to speed by the time we start the challenge on Monday. So it's not too late. Also, if you are in the quarterly CEO productivity membership, tonight is our first fuck up night. So bring your drinks and bring your business obstacles and we're going to have a good conversation. And I can't wait for it. Right. So again, I agree with Pinky Cole. I can't wait to see you fail. Cause let me tell you how new growth is on the other side of that. All right. So I love it. I love y'all. This has been another one. Look, I told y'all I'm a vessel. I don't know how I keep doing it. I'm a vessel. Leticia said, how do I join CEO Productivity Night? You don't. All right. Thank you. Anybody else though, y'all can go to ShayCannon.com/membership. I don't know why Leticia be playing. But anyway, y'all have a great day. Have a great weekend. Bye. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Have a great day, everybody.